system starts here with a 480 volt three-phase feed. It comes from building power, comes into this breaker panel, and then the next step is to take a transformer and step it down to 208 volts AC. The 208 comes to a double conversion UPS, and this UPS is pretty standard equipment in data centers, and it has a battery bank associated with it here. And so this gives a long time of backup in a standard data center. If the power were to go away, this will hold the servers up. Well, on this AC system, we have connected racks of servers that are powered with AC in the conventional manner, like any data center. We also have our rack level demonstration that we talked about before, where we have a rectifier inside the rack that takes 208 volts AC, converts it to 380 volts DC, and we have a couple of servers that are powered off with the DC voltage there. We have a rack here that has 48 volt DC servers or equipment being powered, and that is a proof of concept just to show that they're available. We're not necessarily trying to measure efficiency gains in this particular rack, but it's a nice additional thing to show. The busway that we're using is up overhead, and so 480 volts AC is carried across this busway, and we have circuit breakers that just snap into the bus and provide a 30 amp drop down to the individual racks. For the DC side of the demonstration, we bring feeds out of this same panel, the main breaker panel, and we come over to this rectification unit. This is a rectifier that takes 480 volts AC, converts it to DC, and then for ride through or stability, we have a flywheel attached to the DC bus. And this flywheel provides ride through for probably 20 seconds or so. It's long enough in a conventional, in a data center approach, it would be long enough to bring up a backup generator in case of loss of off-site power. We come down the line, we find that we're powering racks of servers here at 380 volts DC. So there's racks of servers lined up. Then we have the optional rectifier, the alternate rectifier on the other end here, and so this provides the same functionality as the first one, but it gives us the capability to show two different rectifier approaches. To add to the proof of concept, we have DC lights applied above, and so they're turned off today, but they're running from the DC bus at 380 volts, and so we've got four banks of lights to show that capability. So on the AC side, we have equipment that will be eliminated in this process. So this UPS is one of the pieces. The battery bank is another piece. This transformer will no longer be necessary. And so these three pieces of equipment are not used in the DC side. And that's one of the places where we're going to get rid of some of the losses and gain some efficiencies, because there are losses in this equipment inherent in the way that they process power. The other pieces that are going to be affected are actually inside the servers, and so these typical AC power supplies are going to be modified so that the front end is no longer in use, and then the other servers, they bypass that in the power supply, so it's a much simpler, probably a 20% reduction in power supply space or size. For our monitoring system, we've had a manufacturer that has contributed a system that has a main center node here called an info node that collects all the data, and remote units called data nodes are dispersed throughout the system, and then they're connected with voltage and current probes in the system, and they capture waveform data, they can capture power, they can calculate the power consumption, and so we get real-time data, and it's all web addressable, so we can see it on the internet. Because we only have a few servers in each rack, it's not enough to load the UPS to its typical loading values that we find in data centers. So we've added a load bank to try to bring that up to around the 40% level, because we find that that's pretty typical. So this is our load bank on the AC side. And then on the DC system, we have a load bank built over here. Put the load bank in and increase the load on the DC side so that it's typically loaded just like the other. The UPS we use on the AC side is a fairly typical efficiency. It's actually a little bit higher than what we have seen in the field, but some manufacturers have UPSs that are even a higher efficiency, and so we've got one of those installed here as another comparison, because as we know, the DC demonstration savings will be affected by what we're comparing to. And so if we're comparing to a highly efficient system in the beginning, our improvement may not be as much. So it's fair to compare to more than one system. When we're looking at the additional UPS with the higher efficiency, the transformer that comes with it is also an Energy Star transformer, and so that increases the efficiency of that as well. The losses here will be less than the losses we found on the first system, and so that gives us another data point in our comparisons to show data center manufacturers, or builders and users, what results they might be able to expect. And so one of the things that may come out of this effort is that the connectors that we're using are standard AC connectors. They don't have a standardized connector for DC. And so one of the things that may come out of this is the development of a standardized connector for every one of these plugs to go into. And so they've got to design something that's going to be UL listed for breaking DC current. The Nextech system in this demonstration is being used as a rectifier only, but it's also optimized as a power gateway to integrate different power sources. So you could use fuel cells, renewables such as wind and solar. You can use cogen systems. You can use energy. You can put energy storage on the bus as well. And so it integrates all those to supply DC loads. And so you could have computers, telecom, lighting loads, HVAC, and even motors where they're using adjustable speed drives, and you can use the DC power right onto the DC bus of the drive.